Anthony Joshua is lining up Joseph Parker as he seeks to unify the heavyweight titles, but do not expect the fight to happen as early as the Briton suggests. Parker's promoter David Higgins says a February fight against Joshua, which has been touted in the media, will not happen. The Daily Telegraph reported on Wednesday that Joshua, who holds the World Boxing Association, WBA, and International Boxing Federation, IBF, grounds is looking to add the World Boxing Organization, WBO, title held by Parker with a February 3 fight mooted for London. Joshua, who fights Carlos Takam in Cardiff on Saturday, Sunday NZ time, was likely to target Parker next, followed by a blockbuster battle with Deontay Wilder, the World Boxing Council, WBC, champion. "I want to unify all the titles and fight all the champions by the end of 2018, Joshua told the Daily Telegraph. However, the proposed February 3 fight was news to Parker's handlers, and Higgins said it will not happen. For a fight of that magnitude to take place in February, negotiations would need to have already started. Higgins said they had not received any offer from Joshua's promoter Eddie Hearn. Higgins said they would not agree to the 80-20% purse split, in favor of Joshua, which Hearn has suggested in the media. Even at a 20% purse share, a fight against Joshua would be the biggest payday of Parker's career, but it remains short of what Team Parker is after. Point 1, Parker won't be fighting Joshua for 20%. Point 2, Eddie Hearn has not communicated any offer with us. Point 3, we have a united view in our camp that Parker beats Joshua. We think Joshua's chin is suspect, and taking the emotion out of it, the facts back that up. There is a lot of talk around Joshua being laid out in sparring. Parker has never been off his feet as an amateur, in sparring, or as a professional, so we think Parker wins. Point 4, we think it will be a big fight and we will win, but we will do it when the deal is right. 80-20 is not right. For Eddie to put 80-20 in the media without communicating it with us is an interesting tactic. The total purse for Joshua's April title defense victory over Vladimir Klitschko reached $76 million New Zealand dollars, with the two fighters sharing the spoils. But Hearn told the Daily Mail that Parker could not expect an even share. He would have to accept getting less money than Vladimir, who deserved a 50-50 purse split. What's Parker worth? I would say 20% is about right. The plan is for AJ to unify the belts in 2018, and we really would like to create three massive fights next year, Hearn told the Daily Telegraph. February 3 is a potential date, at the O2, against Parker for the WBO belt, or if that doesn't work out, so too is a fight in the Middle East in the first quarter. Wilder is a target as well, in a summer fight. But we are also offering Wilder that February 3 date at the O2 Arena against Dillian White. Ideally, we want Wilder to fight White on February 3, and we have offered him $3 million, $4.3 million, plus U.S. television money, which is worth at least another million, Hearn said. It would be the perfect lead into a Joshua fight, if Wilder could come through that. International boxing writers were skeptical about Parker's chances of beating Joshua when the Kiwi won a points decision over England's Huey Fury in Manchester in September. Leading boxing websites claimed Parker did not pose a serious threat to Joshua. Although Parker improved to 24-0, with 18 knockouts, he did nothing to suggest that he poses a serious threat to the top dog in the division, Anthony Joshua, a report on thesweetscience.com website said. Ringtv.com said Parker must refine his game if he is to be given a serious chance of defeating either Joshua or Wilder in unification bouts. Parker, Joshua and Wilder are all unbeaten in their respective arenas.